a long time ago, Ring Magazine was just kind of like, there's just going to be one WBA champion. We figure the super champion, is like the best out of their three champions. That's super's better than regular and interim, right? And when they first came up with the whole super champion title, it was whenever they unified a belt. If a WBA champion faced an IBF champion and won, then, oh, you're the super champion, right?
Okay.
They used to do that. Now it seems kind of arbitrary. And then for a while they were saying, well, if you're a WBA champion and you've made 10 title defenses, you are a super champion. And guess what? We're going to have like a regular champion to be right beside you. So,
okay.
And by the way, the WBA just came out with a gold title. And I'm like, I'm not going to tell them how to conduct their business, but I do think they should be like real clear. What does that mean? If you hold the WBA gold belt, what does that mean? Does that mean like you're mandatory challenger? And if you're mandatory challenger, okay, mandatory for which title? Interim, regular, or super? I don't know. I couldn't tell you.
Okay. One of the Ring Magazine champions is Canelo Alvarez. He's fighting Danny Jacobs. It's a 50-50 fight.
Yes, it is.
Break it down, Doug.
You just said it. It's a 50-50 fight. I think in terms of style, Danny Jacobs is more of a challenge for Canelo than Gennady Golovkin was. And that's because Golovkin is an aggressive, he's a technical fighter, but he's an aggressive come forward fighter. And Danny Jacobs can fight like that and be very explosive. We saw that when he faced Peter Quillen. He blitzed him, you know?
I remember.
Nobody was expecting it, including Peter Quillen, right? But he's also a brilliant boxer. He was a tremendous amateur. So he's versatile. He doesn't just fight one way. He's used to fighting a stick and move style. He can switch hit. He's taller. He's rangier. Obviously, he's naturally bigger. I think the WBC conducted their 30-day out weigh-in, and Danny Jacobs was just over the light heavyweight limit. And Canelo Alvarez is like at super middleweight limit right now. So that tells you something. That means something. Obviously, he's the bigger man. So he's bigger. He might be faster, although Canelo's got quick hands. He's a very good athlete. He's experienced. He's mature. He's the total package, so to speak. And once upon a time, people used to question his chin. People don't do that anymore. You know, he went 12 rounds with Gennady Golovkin, 12 rounds with Sergey Derevyanchenko. If you're chinny, those guys are going to expose it within 12 rounds. So I think that lets us know this is a tough contest. And I'll say this. In the latest magazine, it's mailing out to subscribers, but it's not in the stores yet. Latest magazine, our guest
check
editor
this out.
Is Kelly Pavlik.
What was it like working with Kelly Pavlik?
Radio it was great. It was great. I forgot how fun it was talking to Kelly.
He has a great sense of humor.
He's a great sense of humor. He's an Ohio guy.
Yes, he is.
My childhood was spent in Columbus, Ohio.
He's a Youngstown.
So I know guys. I know about guys from Youngstown, from Cleveland, from Cincinnati. They're all different. Toledo, Dayton.
Columbus, don't forget.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that was where I lived.
The hood.
Because my parents were graduate students at Ohio State University.